Hi, this is Chef Mick from Tony's Markets. Today we're putting together peas and carrots. They're just natural together. I'm going to start with a little onion. Just take a little slice off the side here. We don't need much. Give you a little technique. We're going to cut this almost all the way through and nice and thin. Not quite to the end here. Nice thin slices all the way down. Now come back in this direction and we'll have some nice finely minced onion. We're also going to cut our carrots up. I like to cut them into little strips. Keep it flat. Keep it as flat as you can. We got them, every piece you cut should be flat, except for that first cut. First cut here, I'm going to lay it flat. Cut it into other strips. We're making little squares. Like this, into the little strips. Let's cut that one again. Pull them together and we'll just cut them into little cubes. All right, very simple. We take the carrots, put them into the boiling salted water with a little bit of onion and the peas. These are going to simmer together for just about 5 minutes. If you like your carrots extra soft, start those first. Simmer together for 3 minutes, 5 minutes, 7 minutes, depends on how firm your peas are and how soft you like your carrots. And we're going to have a beautiful dish of peas and carrots. Now it's all done. We just rinse it out. We're going to add a pat of butter, a little salt and pepper. And it's perfect, peas and carrots. Coming up next, we're going to make a lovely saffron pea risotto with some grilled chicken. Don't go away. Howdy, this is Chef Mick from Tony's Markets. Today we're going to get the peas out of your garden and put them into a beautiful Italian risotto. Risotto is an Italian rice dish where the rice is actually simmered. I'm going to start here with a little bit of butter and a little bit of olive oil. I like to use the piqual olive oil because the piqual olive oil doesn't burn at such a low temperature. To that I'm going to add the risotto. Now Italians will measure one serving, one handful. And that works just fine. This is not a terribly exact recipe. Okay, so we cook these together in the pot, and what we want to do is just lightly toast this rice in the oil. It doesn't cook a long time. What we're looking for is what the Italians call is la perla, where you can see the little pearl of the rice inside there. It's going to probably take at this temperature about 2 or 3 minutes. Now we're going to add saffron. Saffron is very, very expensive. You don't need a lot of saffron, and it's actually the stamens of flowers. So we're just going to take a couple pinches here. As much as you want, and the more the better, obviously. Just put about that much in there. We're gonna let this toast in there as well. It's gonna help bring out the flavor and the color of the saffron into our rice. Okay, and then right next to it here, we've got some stock going. I'm gonna use chicken stock in this case, but you could use vegetable stock. You could just use water if you needed to, but I'm really much happier with the stock. We've got that boiling and simmering because we want to add this and simmer it. So we're ready to go. A little bit of wine. I'm using vermouth, it's just handy. A half a glass to a glass of wine, and that boils away pretty quickly. And then we start adding stock. About a ladle of stock, about a cup, and then we simmer. We're gonna do this in stages where we're gonna add a little bit of stock, simmer for a few minutes, add a little bit of stock, simmer for a few minutes until it's done. And at this altitude, it's probably gonna take 25, 30 minutes. As a matter of fact, I'm gonna go light the grill right now for our chicken kabobs. We've been going about 20, 25 minutes here. It's looking like it's almost done. A few more minutes. I'm gonna take the peas, handful of these peas I just shucked, and I'm gonna put them in this stock that I've been boiling here. And we're gonna let those simmer. Peas probably take about 5 minutes. It all depends on how you like them, how ripe the peas are. There's so many variables. These peas should take about 5 minutes. Okay, I think we're ready here. These peas have gotten nice and cooked. We'll add them in, stir them in there with the last bit of the stock. And I've added them during the last 5 minutes of cooking. This should be done just 5 minutes or so. All right, this is looking almost done, but just a little bit more. We're gonna add a little bit of cream or half and half to this. A little final addition of the cream. And Parmesan cheese. lots of Parmesan cheese. You want to use real Parmesan, Parmigiano Reggiano. Grind it nice and fine, or buy the pre-ground from us at Tony's. All right, a little bit more. And then butter. The Italians are not afraid to use butter. Throw another piece in there. I'm gonna stir this around. I'm gonna take it off the heat and let it sit for about 5 minutes, and we're gonna serve. All right, here we go. Nice plate. I'm gonna normally use a proper pasta or risotto plate, a flat plate like this, but you can adjust or adapt however you've got with whatever you've got. Here we go, nice and creamy there. And we're gonna finish this up with a nice chicken shish kebab. This was marinated in Italian dressing. Let's hide our little spot there. And we'll garnish that, just a little bit of basil and a little crushed red pepper here. And how about some more pepper around the edges here? Here we go. A lovely saffron pea risotto with shish kebabs. Delicious, easy, anyone can do this. You can get this recipe and all the recipes today at diginColorado.com. Let's dig in.